Update. I signed up for Uber Eats. I didn't know how else to do it. It said it needed a four-door car. And there's only one freaking application to sign up for it. So it got approved. I was waiting for the freaking background check. But so now I'm part of regular Uber, which is weird because I have a two-door car. Maybe I shouldn't even post this video. So I activated. It says it's looking for my first ride. I took out all the pizza bags from DoorDash out of my car just in case I get a trip. But I didn't mean to sign in as an Uber driver. I just wanted to have Uber Eats as another option when DoorDash was slow. So
I'm probably not going to get a trip because I'm here in University Park area, Southwest Miami, my old house. It says turn on. There's a thing that says turn on deliveries, and I click it, but it doesn't let me do it. I don't know. This might be a short video. Comment below if you know what I'm doing wrong, what's going on. Inbox, account, all right, opportunities. Where was I where I said, it said like sign up for deliveries. Okay, sign up for deliveries, right? Here we go. Yeah, I wanna sign up for deliveries. Deliver with Uber Eats. Turn on deliveries. Sorry, it looks like there was a problem on our end. Okay, I don't know what's going on. Turn on deliveries. It won't let me turn on deliveries from the work hub thing or the preferences in Uber. All right, well, whatever. I'm just gonna go back to my apartment. But if I get a rideshare opportunity, I also only have 99 miles left in this tank. I'm at a quarter tank of gas. That's not good. I don't really want to do a rideshare. But I mean, I'll take a rideshare if like somebody needs a ride to the airport or to downtown Miami or somebody's drunk at a club, you know? I'll take you home. All right. I don't know what to do.
On the bottom here, it says, you're in a busy area, expect trips soon.
Well, how soon is soon?
And also, does it tell you, like, how many people? Because it's not much room back here, man. I maybe could squeeze four people if one person sits up front and three people squeeze in the back here.
Is my car clean enough for Uber? I feel like I'm a... This is a shameful Uber car. I mean, I love this car, but I need to get it cleaned soon. Especially if this is gonna start hitting.
All right, it sent me an order for $3.20. I didn't have the camera on, but it was like, I don't know. I don't know what I'm doing. It vanished. I guess that let it expire. Man, they didn't give me much time.
Said it would be like 8 minutes.
$3.20, is that including tip? I mean, I don't know what that. This is probably not the right day to do this. Damn, my first Uber offer and I let it expire. All right, I'm accepting this
one. Make a right turn on Southwest 57th Terrace.
What? I accepted this freaking offer. It's only, I can't
make
even.
Make a right turn on Southwest 59th Street.
This is annoying.
I don't know what I'm doing, but I'm doing my first Uber delivery. I mean, rideshare ride. I don't even know how to say it. It's only paying like $4. It says it's only gonna take me 11 minutes or something? 5 minutes? 5 minutes to pick up. I'm picking up a guy. I shouldn't say his name. Alright, this was a bad idea, Mario. Alright.
Make a right turn on Southwest 69th Avenue.
Okay, well, I'm gonna have to turn that fucking thing off because. What's interesting is how I just accepted this order to see what the hell I'm doing, but that's exactly what DoorDash relies on when somebody does their first food delivery. Like, I'm sure they accept like a $3 order going 11 miles because they're just like, I don't know, is this, you know, there's no frame of reference and I don't know how to read the screen yet. I don't know where anything is. Like, shouldn't there be like a little run-through course before you accept your first order? It's like, nope, we're just throwing you into the fire. Wait, this isn't a Mad Dash. We gotta come up with another name. Oh, fuck it. All right, I completed my first Uber delivery. Well, it wasn't a delivery. I just gave a kid a ride from the CVS on Bird and Ludlum to basically around here on 57th Avenue and Coral Way, 8th Street. That was pretty easy. $3.98. Okay, so not a great order or rideshare. I don't know what to call them. Comment below if you know what to call your first trip. It's not a delivery. I didn't deliver. I mean, I delivered a person. He was surprised. You know, the funny thing is, this kid, it was a cool kid. I was a little chatty Kathy. I used to complain when I would use Uber. I just shut up. No one wants to talk about Uber and your experiences. Shut the fuck up. And then here I am going like, whoa, there, I'm a DoorDasher. I just signed up because I wanted to do Uber Eats and I just fucking made a mistake and now you're my first client. And he's like, hey, he's a nice kid. He was like, you know, having a conversation with me. He had an Uber shirt on. I thought I was getting trolled, dude. I thought I was getting like inside job. Like, I thought he was a plant, a mold. Like, Uber. Because, I mean, watching that, we talked about the Uber TV show, Super Pumped. And he knew who the Uber CEO was and everything. He's a smart kid. Because, like, in that show, they have a thing where they can control, like, who gets to ride and who doesn't. Like, it's called grayballing, like, shadow banning. But I'm like, well, they could probably like test out, you know, sniff out new Uber drivers by being like, okay, this guy's doing his first delivery. All right. You know, like there's like a control room. It was like, all right, have a kid meet him at the CVS on Bird and Ludlum. Let's see how he does in his first delivery. First trip. Whatever. All right. So I've made $3.98 on Uber rideshare. He was surprised that I had a two-door car too, so I'm probably not supposed to be doing this. Maybe Uber thinks that I have a regular Kia Forte, but I don't plan on doing Uber rideshare consistently, so, you know, maybe I'll turn it on if DoorDash is slow. But honestly, I just want to figure out how to do Uber Eats. But all right, so let's see. Last trip, I got 1 point. See earnings and activity. Oh, look at this. I need 1,199 more points to unlock Diamond. and get 350. So I got to do 2,000 delivery trips? Okay. 299 more and I get gold. I don't know.
Where's this money going? I haven't even set up my bank account or anything, man. What the hell, man? Travis Kalanick, holla at your boy. I was telling him, I don't think that Uber... I was watching that... I watched that damn TV series. It's actually pretty good. They use some Pearl Jam songs. And Quentin Tarantino actually, like, narrates part of it. It's actually pretty well done. Uma Thurman plays Ariana Huffington. I didn't know she was on the board of Uber. But by today's standards, what that guy did, like, let his company kind of, like, was a... Dude, I mean, it's a startup. One of the biggest startup ideas in the history of the fucking internet. So they had a couple wild drunken nights in Miami and, you know, somebody grabbed somebody's ass. Like, what? Compared to the fucking Mad Men days? And the shit that even I saw, you know, working at a fucking newspaper in the 2000s? Early 2000s? Give me a break. Whatever. I understand that level of position, but I don't really know if what that guy was just a passionate... Well, then, you know what? Everybody's that's got an iPhone in their pocket, Steve Jobs was an asshole too. Right? Bill Gates? Fuck. He's one of the most evil motherfuckers in the planet. Right? We all still use Windows, right? Yeah. I don't have it. I liked that TV show. I was rooting for the CEO of Uber. I'm like, yeah, you show him. Motherfucker. In that show at the end, I'll see if I can find a link to it. He goes on a kind of a mad dash, the CEO of Uber, at the end of that. He's like, you admit it, you love riding in my fucking cars. It's my ideas. You fucking appreciate and you take advantage of. It's like a fucking mad dash right there. I'll play it.
I know what you say about me, what you think about me, what people think. Am I good with it? Does it matter? No. It does not. You know, the times we live in, they condemn what I've had to do to make this thing work. But here's the truth, my truth. Sometimes to change the world, you need to do whatever is necessary to take a no and turn it into a yes. If that means acting like an asshole, being an asshole, I'm an asshole.
You know what?
And I'm not alone in that.
It's not a mad dash.
Everybody's favorite poet, the asshole. It's an exuberant. Now is later to win. Here's a roster for
exuberant.
You. It's asshole.
Exuberant.
Jobs, asshole.
Exuberant.
Asshole.
Exuberant.
I rant. Would say it, but I'm actually scared to.
My first
and if you think I'm wrong
rant.
By any of that, just go read the court cases, the articles for yourself. You know what?
And I'll do that
don't.
When I
just sit there
do Uber Eats as well.
And dreaming about everything
and
you would
go
do
off
if
on
you
a tangent.
So goddamn nuts. At least admit this. You love riding in my cars. You love that they show up at your whim. You love all the stuff that's come since as a direct result of my innovations. So be virtuous, be better than me, and write me off. But while you're cheering for me getting screwed, just remember how secretly grateful you are for everything I did for you, everything I gave you.
Exuberant. Exuberant? Exuberant. Alright, I didn't say this on the last video, so don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe with a beep, 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 beep. And if you think I'm sus, then subscribe. Always tip your delivery driver, people. And your rideshare driver. Now that I'm a rideshare driver, because we're special. Or no, wait, I'm special.